Hello everyone, I am Siddharthan. Currently in our machine learning course, we are discussing about probability for machine learning, and in today's video, we are going to discuss what is meant by a Poisson distribution. Okay, so this Poisson distribution is a very important concept that we often encounter when it comes to data analysis and data science. So in this video, I'll give you a detailed explanation on this topic. Okay, so before getting started, in case you are watching my videos for the first time, hi. In this YouTube channel, I'm making a hands-on machine learning course with Python. And if you want to learn this course from the beginning, I'll give the link of my course playlist in the description of this video. You can check that out. With that being said, let's get started with today's video. Okay. So first of all, let's try to understand what is meant by this Poisson distribution. Okay. So this is the formal definition of this kind of distribution. So a Poisson distribution is a probability distribution that measures how many times an event is likely to occur within a specified period of time. Okay, so there is a specific time period and there is some event that is happening, and this event is happening repeatedly. Okay, so let's say that we are taking a time duration of 1 hour, and let's say that an event is happening for 10 times in that 1 hour. And this type of event, this type of distribution is called as a Poisson distribution. So there is a specific time period and there is a specific event that happens for a repeated number of time. Okay, so this is called as a Poisson distribution. So let's try to understand what is the significance of this. What is the significance of understanding this distribution? So Poisson distribution is used to understand independent events that occur at a constant rate within a given interval of time. So this is very similar to this above definition. So what we are trying to explain here is, so these kind of independent events, so these can be random events, and these random events occur at a constant rate. The rate at which it happens is almost constant. So in the previous example that I have given you, the rate is 10 times per hour, right? So this understanding of rate is very helpful for us to plan for the future. Okay, so this is the significance for it. So it will make more sense once we understand the examples for this. Okay, so let's consider some interesting examples of Poisson distribution. So first one can be number of accidents occurring in a city from 6 p.m. to 10 p.m. Okay, so let's take this particular time period, 6 p.m. to 10 p.m. in the evening, and this is a very active time period, right? So there will be a lot of vehicles that will be going, and we are trying to find how many number of how many accidents occur in a city in this particular time period. So let's say that there are about 300 accidents happening in a city. So if we have this information, we can plan for the future. So once we have this information, so as I've told you, we have 300 accidents happening in this particular 4 hours time period. So what we will try to do is find the probability that, what is the probability that there will be 400 accidents occurring in a particular day, or what is the probability that there will be only 200 accidents that is happening in a day. So these are the different questions we can ask, and this particular type of distribution will help us to understand them. So as I have told you, in this case, we are, let's assume that on an average, there are about 300 accidents happening. So the probability that there will be 1,000 accidents happening will be very less, right? So there is not going to be 1,000 accidents happening. So we can say that there is a very less probability for 1,000 accidents to occur. And what is the probability that there will be 350 accidents happening in this particular time period in that city? So the probability of this is quite high, right? So the probability of 350 accidents is more, whereas the probability of 1,000 accidents is very less in this particular example. So that is the important insight we can get from it. And now the other example we can think of is the number of patients arriving in an emergency room between 10 p.m. to 12 p.m. So this is another typical example we take for Poisson distribution. So in this case, we try to find what in an average number of patients that appear in an emergency room. So once you have this information, you can plan the number of beds and other medical equipments that are required. So this is the other importance of Poisson distribution. So the other simple example you can think about is how many views does your blog gets in a day. So in this, the time duration is one day, it's 24 hours, and how many views we are getting. Okay, so these are some example of Poisson distribution, and once we have this numbers, we can find what is the probability that an event occurs a specific number of time. Okay, so we can find the probability of different numbers, as I have told told you. So if there are about 300 accidents happening, we will try to find the probability for different numbers. So what is the probability that there will be 100 accidents? What is the probability that there will be 250 accidents? Or what is the probability that there will be 500 accidents? So we will try to find the probability of these different numbers. Okay, so this is how Poisson distribution works. So now let's try to understand this mathematically. So there is a particular formula for this to find the probability. So this is it. Okay, so here P of x, so which means the probability of x is equal to e power minus lambda in lambda power x and divided by x factorial. Okay, so this is the formula for Poisson distribution. Here x represents the number of times the event occurs. Okay, so as I have told you in the previous slide that there can be 100 accidents happening and there can be 500 accidents happening. So we are trying to find the probability of these different numbers. So x can take any number of values. So it can be 100, it can be 200 or anything. Okay. And lambda. So lambda represents mean number of events. So what is the normal average of events that is occurring? So in the previous example, I have told you that the mean number of accidents that occur is about 300, right? So in this case, lambda will be 300 and x can be any value. So it can be 100 or 3 or 100 or 200 or 500. And lambda is the mean accident value, which is 300. Okay. And we have the E. E is nothing but the Euler's number, and Euler's number is almost equal to 2.71828. So this is nothing but the one which we take for natural logarithm, right? So this is the value of E. Okay, so we have X, which is the number of times the event occurs. So we are trying to find the probability of X. Okay, and we have P of X is nothing but the probability of this particular number of times, and we have lambda, which is the mean number of events that is actually happening, and x factorial, we know what is a factorial. So factorial of 5 is nothing but 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So it is the factorial of a number. Okay, and e is nothing but Euler's number. So when you plug the values in this particular formula, you will get the probability for the number of events. Okay, so this is how we generally make curves for Poisson distribution. So we have different types of curves for different values of lambda. We know that lambda represents the mean number of events. So let's say that there is a particular event happening and there is about average number of event is 1, and in this case the second one is average number is 4, and in this case it's 10. Okay, so this is how you will get a graph in this particular example. So this changes for different example actually. So in the y-axis we have the probability of x, probability of the number of events, and in the x-axis we have the number of times the event is happening. So let's say that so in this we have 1 2 3 4 5 and up to 20. So let's say that the event is happening for 5 times, and we try to find the probability when the mean number is 4. So let's take this example. So let's say that there are about 4 accidents happening in a in an area, and we try to find the probability that what is the probability that there will be 5 accidents happening. Okay, so if you just try to find the probability with this particular green line, you will get the probability for it. Okay, so similarly you will get different curves for different values of lambda. So this is one such example. Okay, so this is how you can find the Poisson distribution. So you can also take some examples and solve some problems regarding this Poisson distribution. Okay, so here the y-axis, as I've told you, y-axis represents the probability, and x-axis represents the number of times the event occurs. So 5 means, so let's take the x-axis is 5, that means the y-axis would be what is the probability that the event will occur 5 times. So if we take the x value as 10 and the y value will be what is the probability that the event will occur 10 times. So you can also understand this with in terms of this particular formula. So let's say that we want to find the probability for x is equal to 10. So x is equal to 10 represents an event will occur 10 times in a particular time period. So P of x will be what is the probability that the event occurs 10 times. So you will get a probability value which will lie between 0 and 1. Okay, so this is all about Poisson distribution. Now let's try to understand where this can be useful when it comes to data science or data analysis. So what is meant by data analysis? What is meant by a data science? Data science is something where we use several statistical and machine learning models to derive insights from data. So once we derive these insights, it will be very helpful for several reasons. So when you have these insights, you can make better business decisions and other informations as well. So one such example which we can think of when it comes to Poisson distribution in data science is insurance companies. So let's say that there is an insurance company, and they want to set insurance cost for their customers. So what they can do is take a time period and find what is the number of, so let's say that the time period is 1 year, and in this particular year, what is the number of accidents that is happening? Okay, so let's say that there are about 10,000 accidents happening in a year. Okay, so based on these number, they can find some Poisson distribution, and they can also find what is the probability that there will be a particular number of accidents, as I have told you. And based on this information, they can set insurance prices, which is profitable for them. So this is one such example where we can use Poisson distribution to understand the data better in the case of data science and data analysis use cases. Okay, so there are several other such examples. So you can also do more research on this particular topic. So that is all about Poisson distribution, and I hope you have understood all the things covered in this video, and I'll see you in the next upload. Thanks for watching.